No. What are you doing?
Oh, stop disturbing me!
Can you stop walking around? You're gonna make a whole
mess. No! What's your problem
this time? Did your boyfriend break up with you again? No! Have you grown fat? You're not buying body
image.
Oh, I think I know what is wrong with you.
No!
Okay, no. Okay. But honestly, what's your problem this time? SPM is so near and I don't know what course to take. It's just SPM. Come on, PT3 is nearer. Why don't you just take science?
Science? Are you even my sister? Don't you remember? I failed physics. I failed chemi. I failed bio and you want me to take science.
You know what? I don't remember this kind of thing because it's a disgrace to the family, you know. You fail? Okay, do you know her? Do you know her? She tells you you fail bio, chemi, and physics, and you can tell everybody this is a disgrace, man.
Okay, quiet. We forgot something.
What?
We forgot to introduce
ourselves. Oh, yeah, we haven't! Okay. Hello, Carl. My parents are having sister, Justina. And this is my very good sister, Lima.
I'm so thirsty. Why do you only have room temperature soda?
Seriously? I asked you to help me with science project, not drink soda. But since you're here, so leave it be.
What are you doing?
I'm cooling a drink. In this basin, there is salt and ice. Salt lowers the temperature of ice. So when the ice melts, it becomes colder. And if you leave it in the same state for a few hours, you could actually freeze the water. Didn't you learn this in like primary school? It's like general science.
I told you I feel all the science subject, right? But yeah, by the way, you know, chemistry is such a boring subject.
Boring? What have you been doing in class? Sleeping, eating, what you do? Do you not pay attention?
Okay, but the only chemistry I know about is the chemistry of me and Kiyomi.
Alright, I'm about to die of a heart attack. Come on, Kiyomi is not that cute. I mean, look at those two, they are hotter. Come on, these are the hotter ones, right? Anywho, maybe I can show you a few science experiments that, you know, you could make you choose a course or something. But first, let me call up the genie.
Genie, you do know we're in a science lab, right? Not some magic room or something.
Seriously, you're too clueless. But if you guys want to watch this genie appear, can I hear a round of applause, please? Can you be patient now and move back, step back? Actually, you're right. This is not a magic show. This is... Since we're in the science lab, I will show you something that can be defined with science. Inside this bottle, there is hydrogen peroxide. And what you have seen is a catalyzed decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. In this experiment, there's manganese dioxide taped here. So when I release the cap, the manganese dioxide falls into the hydrogen peroxide. The manganese dioxide is a catalyst, meaning that it's a small release of energy that speeds up a chemical reaction. That's why you can when hydrogen peroxide is decomposed, it produces oxygen, and that's why you can see oxygen coming out from the top. It's magic.
Okay, cool.
Now watch this without being covered. That is how you get the genie about the
just genie. I want something more, you know, more interesting, you know. What about volcano? But not the baking soda and vinegar one, you know.
Come on, you think I'm that dumb? Huh? Yeah. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Lava Shooter 3000! 3000? I added 3000 because it sounded cool at the moment, you know.
Sounded cool.
Okay, so basically, this is what I'm gonna do. This is potassium iodide. So now watch what happens when I add this into the volcano. Okay. working? Is it working? Is it not working? Is it not? I don't think it's working. Oh, it's working. Is it? Okay, it's taking some time, but... Actually, in the previous experiment, we show you a catalyzed decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. This is another experiment that shows the same thing, but in this case, you guys will probably know it as elephant toothpaste.
Elephant toothpaste.
I want to ask you one very simple question. Have you all seen an elephant brush their teeth?
No.
Okay, basically, the reason why it's called elephant toothpaste is because instead of smoke coming out, there is soap mixed with the hydrogen peroxide. Therefore, when the decomposition reaction happens, it shoots out the bubbly soap. That's why it looks like toothpaste. And the reason why it's called elephant toothpaste is because we get it now. Okay, and this is let me just do it again to show you guys a better. So, okay, the reason this happens so fast, so the reaction is exothermic, meaning?
The product is hot.
See? It's not that hard, is it, chemistry? Oh, come on. Anything else?
Yeah, but you need to step up your game.
Oh my god, are you eating that?
Yeah.
Put that down! It's for the next experiment!
Wait, you poisoned me, right? Oh my god, stomach. Oh, fever?
Then die! Get up, like edible lah! Oh my goodness, you are such a drama queen.
Don't help me, bitch!
You can stand up by yourself, right? Okay, for this experiment, we'll be needing 2 volunteers.
Please, someone.
Meeny, meeny, my I see you, come out! Yes, you!
Okay.
So basically, we're gonna light the bunsen burner. And inside, this boiling tube has potassium chlorine. So basically, if anything happens to you guys, don't worry. We have a fire blanket, you guys won't die. It's a fun experiment. But we gotta give it a while. So why don't you guys introduce yourselves? What's your name?
Wait, I borrowed my mic off the table.
What's your name?
I'm Zara.
From?
CBN, Carmen Bukit Nanas.
I'm Anissa.
So, okay. What I need you guys to do is, you see this thing right here? You have to throw it in once I remove the bunsen burner, which is going to take a while. So...
Whoa.
Wait, this is not the actual experiment, people. Don't.
Whoa.
The actual experiment is actually way much better than this, but... It's melting. And it's taking such a long time. So Irene, remember the other time you bought the dress from Cotton On?
Yeah.
I ripped it the other day.
Seriously?
Yeah.
I spent hundreds on that.
Well, what? It was an ugly dress anyway. On you, at least.
Ouch.
It looks
nice on you,
lah. It looks better on me. Okay, I'm so sorry, guys, that you have to wait for this. This is going to take a long time to melt this thing. Okay, Zara, can you come here? Okay. Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna throw the jelly inside. There are potassium chlorine. So basically, this shows the thermal decomposition of potassium chlorine. Okay, so when potassium chlorine is melted, it produces potassium chloride and it also produces oxygen. And if you guys don't understand, this is the part that we need. This is for oxygen, this is for potassium chloride. So therefore, when the oxygen is produced, there is enough oxygen to ignite the candle. So when the sucrose, or sugar, is mixed with the oxygen, it produces carbon dioxide, heat, and water, therefore resulting in a fire-like substance. Mm.
lacking something.
What am I lacking this time? You.
I think you're lacking...
I'm lacking...
The beauty of art?
The beauty of art.
Ladies and gentlemen, please excuse my sister. I think she's about to take a lesson.
What?
Come on, this is a science lab and we are doing science projects. There's a reason why there is art stream and science stream in Malaysia, not art science stream. What are you going to do? Like, come on.
I'm going to prove you wrong.
For sure.
Okay, so here I have rose syrup and on top of it is orange juice, so I'm gonna pour it out, okay? Okay, so see, isn't it?
But it's still prettier than you, so I better look at it right now.
How did you do it? Okay, all of this is density. The rose syrup is concentrated with sugar, therefore it has a heavier density. As for the orange juice, it has less sugar and is lighter, so it will stand on top of the rose syrup. The amount of sugar can affect the liquid's density.
Oh, I didn't know you were that smart. Anyways, remember your drink earlier? I don't think it's ready.
From Sushi, but I feel like having a slurpee.
Oh, slurpee?
Yeah.
Excuse me. Slurpee, do you know how far is the nearest 7-Eleven? You have to take the lift down, go to concourse floor, then you have to walk the nowhere and find 7-Eleven. You want to get your support
to the right.
Oh, to the right, okay. I didn't know that and I don't care. So,
I have anything to drink.
I think I have this one. Okay, this is one I pre-prepared earlier, so I
as you guys can see, it already became ice.
Oh, okay. Oh my god. Okay, I'm sorry that I ripped your dress. I'm sorry I, you know, messed up your date with him. And I'm sorry I made you feel as bad.
Yeah, I'm gonna freeze you soon.
I'm sorry, go, please don't freeze me. I'm sorry for all the bad things I've done to you. And please don't kill me. I still have like 30 more years to live, you know?
31 years, you might as well die to me. Calm down. This is all science, okay? When soda is produced, large amounts of additives and carbon dioxide bubbles are pumped into the water to create a bubbly, sugary soda pop. These additives are called solutes, and when solutes are added into water, the freezing temperature of the water decreases. Without the extra carbon dioxide, the soda can freeze much more quickly.
Are you sure you're my sister? Last time, I just remember only last month you asked me, is carbon dioxide edible? Are you sure you're home? Who are you? What are you doing in my room?
I don't know, ma. You
need to learn, ma. Still growing, ah. 17 years old already. SPM, ma. Coming soon.
Okay.
After all the mess we have done, I'm very sorry. Have you chosen the course?
Okay.
You're gonna take.
I'm gonna take
the science course.
What?
I make pretty colors. I make ashes come up from a bottle.
You were trying to prove me wrong.
I was trying to kill you, actually. Honestly.
Ouch. Okay.
Anywho, that's it from Team Pudu.